As you may or may not know, I have the pleasure of photographing many weddings every year, and this is one of the couples from last year. I thought it'd be nice to send them a thank you card because I really enjoyed taking their pictures, and I'm going to use one of the pictures we took on the day to do it. So I've got the picture on the screen and I've got my layers palette open. So what I'm going to do first of all is to make a copy of the background layer simply by clicking it and dragging it down onto the new layer icon and letting go. So now I have an exact copy of the original picture. And I've done that because I want to have a border all the way around my picture and I want it to be made of the same image. So I need to shrink this picture down a little bit, and we do that by going to Edit and choosing Free Transform. Now when you click that, you get some little corner handles appearing all the way around your picture. Just hang on to any of them, doesn't matter which one, and click it and drag your image in. Now as you do, you'll see you'll be able to shrink and resize your picture. But that kind of looks a little bit odd. I don't think the bride wants to look a little bit shorter and fatter. I don't think she'd thank me for that. So if I hold the Shift key as well as dragging in, now you can see I can't actually resize it other than keeping it proportional. Probably about there is about right. Okay, we can now drag that picture off to the middle, around about there. Perhaps that's just a wee bit small so we can make it slightly bigger. Now you can keep doing this all the time that you haven't clicked the tick. Once you click the tick, you kind of commit to the change. I'm pretty much happy. That's about in the middle. We'll click the tick. Now you can see we've got two pictures over the top of each other, but the one underneath, I want to be able to see that a little bit different to the one on over the top. So let's click that on the layers palette to make that active, and then we'll come up to Image, Adjustments, Hue Saturation. And using this tool, we're going to make our underneath image go to a sepia tone. So we'll click the Colorize tab, and it kind of goes this sort of sickly red color. It's not particularly pleasant at all. But if I change the Hue slider, I can put a little bit of sepia tone in there, perhaps just drop the saturation down a wee bit. And I think I'm going to bump up the lightness as well, just to give it a sort of bleached out look. Yeah, there we go. That's the sort of effect I'm looking for. When you're happy, click OK. So now you can clearly see the difference between the background and the main picture itself. But the heads are kind of poking over the top. It just looks a little bit uncomfortable. So I'm going to enlarge the image underneath. And I need to do that using Free Transform. But if you try and access Free Transform right now, you can't get to it. It's grayed out. That's because the default setting is when you bring a picture in, it comes in as a background with a little padlock on it. And I want to get rid of that padlock. So I do that by double-clicking the background layer. A new layer box pops up, gives you the chance to name it, call it anything you like. Call it background if you want to. But just click OK, and your padlock has now mysteriously vanished. And if we go back to Edit and Free Transform, you now can actually access that from the menu. So let's click the Free Transform, and we can just drag this up and out, again holding Shift as we go. Now we start off having a bit of trouble down here because we're going to run out of room fairly fast, because now I want to go to those corner handles and they've disappeared off the edge of the page because I want to twist it around a wee bit. So neat little trick, if you hold Control, press 0 on the keyboard, that'll zoom your image out so you can find those corner handles again, and I can just twist the image over just to give it a bit of style, bit of character. There we go, that looks pretty good. And we'll just see if we can bring their eyes up like that. Perfect. Okay, we'll click the tick. Okay, so we can kind of see how this is working. Let's fit that back onto the screen. The picture underneath is looking good, but the one over the top I think just needs an edge or a border just to lift it off. So let's click that to make it active. Go down to our layer styles. Let's put good old drop shadow in. You can't beat a bit of drop shadow. And we'll just put a bit of drop shadow in, bit of size, bit of spread maybe, and a bit of distance. And we'll just bring the angle round a little bit. There we go. That's kind of looking like it's now floating over the top of the image. Fine, that's good. A bit of text, I think, is in order now. I'd like to write thank you along the bottom. So we'll grab the text tool and we'll just type it in. Just click down the bottom here and just start typing. So thank you. Tell you what, shall I spell that correctly? How's that? That's better. We can move that into place, round about in the centre there. We can make it a little bit larger if you like. Let's highlight it And we'll increase it up to about 60 points. Yeah, that's better. That actually fills the lower part of the screen quite nicely. Okay, so I've got my card, the front of the card made. Now all I need is the back of the card. Because if we're going to print this out, we've got to have a back side and a front side. And we do that, first of all, by flattening this whole image down. So we'll come up to Layer and choose Flatten Image. That'll collapse all of our layers down into one single image. Now, I want the back of my card to be just plain white, so I'm going to reset my colours, little black and white squares, to black and white. But if you wanted a coloured back to your card, of course, change your background colour, mine's white, to anything you like, and it'll pick up the colour in the next step. Okay, enlarge our canvas. Image, canvas size. And what I want to do is to double the size of the canvas. Now, this isn't too hard mathematically. 5.99 is near enough 6, so doubling it is 12. But if your maths is, like mine, not so good on the bigger numbers, just change the units away from inches or centimetres to percent and type in 200%. That'll make it twice the size it was before. Another important thing is we have to anchor it in the right place. We have to anchor it in the centre and on the right-hand side, so it expands out towards the left. If we didn't, we'd have a bit of canvas either side and you wouldn't be able to fold the card correctly. Okay, we'll click OK to that, fit that onto the screen, and now we have the front of our card and we have the back of our card as well. Now that's pretty good, that's ready to print, but one thing I found from doing a few of these is if you print it out right now, what you'll find is you don't really know where the edge of your card is because it's just pure white. So one final little touch is we'll go up to Select, and then we'll select All, and we'll go to Edit and Stroke, and we'll put a very small, just a couple of pixels, 2 pixels, located on the inside, click OK, and lose the selection. Select and deselect, and that puts a very thin black line around it, and that's your trimming line, so when you print it out, you know if you cut it out exactly on the line, then it'll fit perfectly and fold exactly. And there you go, you've now got a lovely thank you card ready to be printed and sent.